Alright, so guys, I felt like it was important to make this video to make more of the Fallout 76 community aware that you are able to get this weapon currently this week. Keep in mind, this is just going to be for the week. As you can see, the weekly weapon challenge is something called the Unstoppable Monster, and the name definitely suits what it is. You're just going to have to complete this weekly weapon challenge to get it, which it's pretty simple to do. Keep in mind, you are going to have to be in survival mode. As you can see, you're just going to have to kill a human-like creature with a melee weapon. This was extremely simple. I just took out a scorched enemy. Also, you're going to have to cook a meal while intoxicated. I don't know exactly how much alcohol you have to drink to be intoxicated, but I just drank one and bada bing, bada boom, I had it completed. So I guess it may depend on what you're drinking too. But yeah, this is also something really simple to do. In case you don't know how to get beer, I mean, you can make it, or you can just purchase it by, for example, going to the White Springs Station vendor. So yeah, hopefully that helps for those of you that may be a little confused on how to get beer. I mean, for the most part though, like I was saying, all these challenges are simple. Anyways, also you're gonna have to claim a workshop while mutated. This can be kind of tedious, especially if you are not mutated. But if you are, this should be straight to the point. Just go to a workshop immediately and claim that bad boy. Also, you're gonna have to eat raw meat. I mean, wow, right? This is really, really tough. Oh, man. Shoo-wee. Woo! Eating raw meat. Oh, how are we going to do that? Oh, man. Next up here, as you can see, we're going to have to kill a critter while starving. This was actually the most difficult task out of all of these tasks. And the reason why is because it was just time consuming. I literally just took like psychotads, medics, just things that would pretty much make me hungry and thirsty, medicine, and then just waited it out. Once I was able to officially take out a critter though, I went over to White Springs Golf Club, and over here, you can actually find some little frogs in the pool area here, so I just took out one of those and yeah, had it completed. And hands down, this weapon is amazing. Highly recommend getting it. This is actually the reason why I'm making the videos, because I want more of the community to get this. I don't want you all to miss out on this. This is an absolute beast of a weapon. As you see, the perks on this, it comes with the Bloodied effect, which this increases your damage the lower your health is. As most of you may know, Bloodied is an extremely useful build. It's just, of course, a little bit more dangerous because you are lower health. But getting that Nerd Rage to proc while you're low health, man, it is great. You typically do some insane damage. As you can see, we are up to 1600 damage. Now this plus the ninja perk card and performing a sneak attack on an enemy, you're going to be doing around 5000 damage. Now that is ridiculous. Once again, the reason why I'm making this video is because of how good this weapon actually is. I want to try to make more players aware that this is in the game, because it is extremely worth it. Highly don't recommend missing this. Not only does it come with a bloody effect, it also comes with 40% more power attack damage, and you take less damage when power attacking. This would be an absolutely amazing combination to use with a full Cavalier set. In case you don't know what that is, you take less damage when sprinting. So you can just easily sprint up to your opponent and use a power attack on them to pretty much take them out in one hit. I mean, after all, in the end, it's totally up to you if you want to grind for this or not, but it's kind of cool that we can get this good of a weapon without having to worry about RNG. We just have to simply complete this weekly weapon challenge while we still can. I'm Maverick though, everybody. Thanks for taking the time watching and listening. If you found this enjoyable, consider leaving a like. Your guys' support is highly appreciated. And hey, maybe if you're new around here, consider subscribing for more future Fallout 76 content. As always though, all of that is totally up to you. Thanks for taking the time watching and listening. Until next time, peace.